Okay, welcome back to Dark Souls 3, everyone. I think today we're going to continue on with just a few little things. I do want to test some things out. We did get that Path of the Dragon gesture, and I want to test something to see if what I think is correct. Because if we remember, in Aerithel Dungeon, there was something that said gesture required. And it had a dragon there doing the Path of the Dragon gesture. And sorry about not being able to upload in the last week. I've actually been doing a lot of university work for my last year. And believe it or not, I've actually been creating it's a very important assignment. I'm basically working on my game project for the final year of my course. I'll just talk about this before I give her the Umbral Ash here. Basically, I've gotten to create whatever I wanted. We basically pitched our own ideas, and mine as being one of the ideas worked on that was pitched, so I'm really happy about that, but it is a lot of work, and that's one of the reasons I haven't been able to upload in the last week or so. Because I think, like, the next prototype for this game is due this Friday coming, and I don't know when this will be uploaded, but I think that is... Shit, I don't even know the date today, so I'm not even gonna say which Friday it is, but it's, this week sometime. It should be, like, the week of this that's uploaded, that this episode's uploaded. And yeah, I just have not had time to do much else than that. And, basically what I'm doing, I'll just skip over our dialogue. We've already handed in this ash before. But yeah, basically what I'm working on is a very Souls-inspired slash Kingsfield-inspired first-person ARPG game. And while it's not going to be a very big game, it's going to be about a 30-minute experience. Or maybe a bit longer. Ooh, Gundyr's stuff. Did we have that before? I'm not sure. It's going to be about a 30-minute experience, or maybe like an hour-long experience, where the player will be going to several different areas in the game, hopefully by the end of this year, when the game's done. And they'll hopefully be able to see that Souls-inspired sort of gameplay. It's more Kingsfield-inspired, really. The gameplay draws a lot from Kingsfield, but the, like, GUI elements and the mechanics for the game draw a lot from Souls games. Which I thought was interesting, and I feel like it's about time that someone makes, even as a student project, like a Kingsfield-inspired game that plays a bit like Kingsfield, but has updated graphics. And, it's being made in Unity, so, I mean, I do have limitations. I would rather make it in something like Unreal Engine 4 or something crazy like that, but for one, I don't think my computer has enough processing power to handle that. And then two, apparently Unreal Engine 4 is just crazy difficult to use over Unity. Like, apparently its interface is just crazy difficult for a beginner to learn how to use, and I'm quite familiar with Unity after 2 or 3 years. So that's just a bit of an explanation as to why uploads have been slow for the last week, or rather non-existent. So we're going to go back to Aerithel Dungeon, and we're going to... where the fuck was Aerithel Dungeon? Yeah, there it is. And we're going to see if this gesture works. Alright, so where was the fastest way to get to this? Might have been that one down the shortcut, maybe? Wait, no, there was a shortcut somewhere else. There was a... shit, it was... I think I know where it is. We'll see. Okay, it's not that way. I think it's this way. There was a shortcut we opened. I don't know if I want to keep using these swords because they're dangerously weaker than I thought they would be. Hello? And just to talk about my game a bit more, I don't want to, like, dwell on it for too long, because really it's only in the prototype stages right now, and there's still a lot more work to do on it. But basically what it's like is, we're just going with, like, a really kind of cliched yet trying to make it interesting fantasy style game, or dark fantasy rather, and just draw on some of that Souls atmosphere and the Kingsfield style world, like the kind of more open worldy sort of feel, I suppose. Not really open world, just large open areas, I suppose, rather than the Souls kind of, oh shit, I shouldn't have fucking done this. Oh, fuck. Rather than the Souls kind of claustrophobic feel, some areas will have that kind of claustrophobia that you see in the Souls games. I'm hoping to achieve that level of, depth in the feel and atmosphere for the game, but, obviously this is, like, my first big kind of project with an actual team of students that are working towards a common goal. Previously it had been, I'd worked in maybe, like, groups of two or three, but now I'm working in a group of six. And, I believe this was the shortcut that we take. No, it wasn't. Shit, where was it? May have been down. I don't want to fuck myself over, though. But yeah, this is my first... Oh, that's it, there, that's it. Yeah, my first, like, six-person group project that... Apparently, or not apparently, I am in charge of organizing, and basically because it was my pitch, I'm the project manager for this assessment. So I have to make sure everything works and goes well, and basically visually and creatively it's my vision for the game, and I have to make sure that vision is brought to fruition. So yeah. Hopefully this works. I'm not sure where you have to do it, but I'm hoping that I am correct. Because where the fuck else would you use this? Gestures. Oh, no. Gestures. Let's see. I will just put it on bow. Path of the Dragon. Okay. We've gone high fantasy all of a sudden. That is one thing that I want to put in the game that I'm working on, like little like destructible environment things like this. It's actually a lot harder to do than you think. you basically have to, it's basically just rigid bodies on things with collision that then they have a sound effect added to them, but if you're doing it with like a crate or something that like breaks open when you're rolling into it, that's actually a bit more difficult, believe it or not. Because you have to model the crate and then have a script or something that either allows it to break into pieces or it's modeled in pieces and those pieces stick together until the rigid body is activated on it. Or it just instantiates, it just deletes the actual crate model. And then in its place instantiates something else that already falls apart when you hit it. Shit. Oh, Archdragon Peak. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy, I got the trophy. That's good. Actually pretty handy for dealing with more than one enemy. It's like snake people. Didn't Seath create snake people as well? So, is this place the handiwork of Oseros the Consumed King? Man, some of these textures just come on, FromSoft. There's literally no textures there. I'm not gonna blame him too much. It's so easy to miss when you're creating a game, especially one that's as detailed as this. And I'm not speaking as if I am an experienced game designer. I've only been doing it for about 2 to 3 years, and that hasn't even been within the industry, but God, it's such a detailed practice. What was that? Oh, hey guys. Oh, well, just let me get this and I'll be out of your way. Okay. They do not like me. A lot of those fucking stones. Lightning gem. All right. Did I come around here? Is this where the broken texture was? Yep. All right. Cool. That's how I'm gonna landmark where I am. Broken textures. Went around there. Yep. All right. Well, what's through here? Oh shit! I almost fell down there. Guys, come on, leave me alone. Leave me alone, guys. Oh shit, there's three of them! I knew that was gonna be a fucking ambush somewhere. I need to change into my katana. That was easy enough. Oh shit. Gross, dude. Actually pretty strong. Least I don't have a follow-up to that. I want some lore on these guys. Drop one of your items, come on. So, what's gonna happen after this series? I feel like we're almost at the end. So what's gonna happen after this is Dark Souls 1 and 2. Gonna get back on track with those. Post commentary for Dark Souls 2, the in-depth lore videos for the DLC. And Dark Souls 1 live com. Do some Dark Souls 3 videos after that on the lore. So after Dark Souls 2 is finished and Dark Souls 1 is finished, I might try and squeeze in some Dark Souls 3 lore videos in between both of them. But man, that's a lot of work. Two series at one time. That's why I've only been doing Dark Souls 3. Especially during university semesters. Maybe during the holidays for my university stuff, I might be able to do. Oh, shit. The lore videos as well as both playthroughs. But man, it's difficult to juggle. Die. Come on. Fall off the cliff or something. All right, cool. Oh, almost missed that. Titanite chunk. Good. I need those. It looks like I can go up that tree. Let's find out. Looks like you can walk up that. I have a feeling that might be possible. Let's see if I can get up higher somehow. Maybe not. Oh shit. Let me know if it is possible to get up there, if I am missing something, because I don't know if it is. You guys probably know better than I do. So, still haven't gotten a bonfire. What's this? Liar ahead, liar ahead. All right. Yeah, didn't expect it to be. Guessing from the liar. Oh, we dropped something. Yes! Yes, lore. Man serpent hatchet. Was that what it's called? Yep. Hatchet of the Serpent Men guarding Archdragon Peak has a unique, broadly curved blade that can sneak past shields. Ooh. Huh, interesting. Not much information on what they actually are, but I'm guessing it's close to what Seath did in Dark Souls 1. where he created these serpent men in the same manner that I'm guessing Aceros did in this game. Can't remember what purpose he made them for. It might have been just a god. What's it called? God sends fortress, but I'm unsure if that's actually correct. Need to go back to Dark Souls 1. Oh my goodness! What the fuck, dude? He's a big boy. Wonder if I can backstab him. Oh my god, he's just a giant one. Alright. Whoa boy. Oh my god, he breathes fucking fire? He's an actual dragon. Alright, I need to be careful. One more hit. There we go. Whew! Large Titanite, cool. Where is the bonfire? Am I just missing it? God, I hope there's a bonfire here. Death. Be wary of right. Hey, buddy. Ring ahead. Okay, cool. Damn, four hits. Am I one-handing? Yes, I am. That's why. Ooh, lightning clutch ring. So, thing I like about, I think Miyazaki games at large, at least with ring placement and item placement, is they always place those items in your path for a reason, and usually at the time or near a time when you might need it, which is nice. And a very good practice for placing items in your game. Is there nothing else around here? This has changed dramatically. Like, this is like Dark Souls 2 atmosphere now. It's really nice. This seems like a static skybox with, like, I'm just trying to think, because, like, making my game right now, we have a static skybox, but we have, like, dynamic clouds that roll over in a certain pattern, and I'm wondering if that's just a particle effect or if it's actually a cloud system. Because their cloud system doesn't look like it moves. Which is fine. It still looks really nice. Especially the mountains. See, I'm also wondering if the mountains are modeled or if that is part of the skybox. To me, it looks like part of the skybox, but I've been wrong before. Plenty of times. Can I have a bonfire, please? Please? Please, can I have... Where the fuck is a bonfire? Is it just... You gotta be shitting me. You have to be fucking joking. And I can't lock on to... I can't lock onto it. Great. I'm guessing I don't fight it. I'm guessing I ring the bell. Let's see here. Alright. Let's see. Let's ring the bell. Nope. Do I not ring the bell? Alright, I'm guessing I just don't fight it then. Goodbye. This seems like a bad decision. Ring ahead? Oh man, this seems like a bad decision. Goodbye. So, do I fight it? Or do I not? I did 16 damage to it, so I'm guessing I don't. But it could be like the amygdala fight where you deal damage to it based on where you're hitting it. You shitlord. Using spider shields? Oh no, bucklers, alright. Come on, let me get backstab. I'm gonna switch to my Walner's Greatsword. Alright, I've gotta be missing something. I've gotta be missing like a short, like, this is a shortcut obviously, but maybe this isn't a very big area, and there's no bonfire in it. Actually, what am I doing? I should ember up. You shit. Didn't even matter. Boop. Boop, boop, boop. Ugh. Actually, I should have known that big one was going to breathe fire, judging from the fact that these ones breathe fire. I thought they were just casting pyromancies. Ow, I dodged into that. Ooh, it's a close one. Alright, let's deal with you. Oh, shit. Is there a fog door? Yes, then it's a boss. I mean, how did I miss that? That leads up. Alright, well, I have a feeling he drops down on me if I go below him. Lightning gem. Okay, they drop lightning gems too. Don't mind me. I'm just gonna grab this. Oh, I'm gonna read that just as soon as I get away from him. All right. Well. Ancient Dragon Great Shield. Let's see. A wooden shield bearing the image of an ancient dragon very slowly regenerates HP. Oh, this is like, was the Adjudicator's Shield stamina or HP in Demon Souls? I feel like it was HP, maybe? It could be stamina as well. The painting is the result of an exquisite but painstaking technique. Lingering, undying traces of the ancient dragons can still be seen in their descendants, the man serpents. Oh, okay. Though they have fallen far from grace. So the man serpents are descendants of the ancient dragons. Interesting. Probably malformed versions of the ancient dragons that were fucked up by Aceros. So what exactly am I meant to do in this fight? I'm not sure if I'm meant to fight him. Oh, I did a bit of damage then. I don't know what I hit. No! What did I hit then? Was I hitting his tail? No? Okay. Very unsure of what I'm meant to be doing. Okay, I'm guessing I run this way then. Alright. I totally didn't even realize it was a way to go this way. Oh no, you gotta be fucking joking. No! Oh, he kills the other guys as well. Sweet! Oh, I hope... Please don't be a gimmick boss. Please actually allow me to fight it. Don't be like the fucking... Dragon God from Demon Souls. Don't do that again. I mean, this is already a bit cooler than that, but... Oh, no. No. I'm sorry to whoever was yelling at me, go fucking left when I was fighting it the first time. Fuck you. I hope there's not just like an off switch for the dragon. Hey there. Shit. Well, that makes looking at this area easy. There we go. Item. Yeah, twinkling. Please no hurt. Oh shit. Please no hurt. Please no hurt. Please no hurt. Alright, well... What's going on then? Oh, that looks fucking cool, dude. That looks so cool. I like how they're making this entire area like a boss fight. That's really awesome, though. Like a boss is just happening while you're fighting. Oh, I got Estus back. Try a plunging attack. Please tell me there's not just an off switch. Oh, hey man. Oh, poised through that. Oh, fuck. God fucking... Oh, shit. No! Don't let me fall off. Oh. All right, that was close. Whew, all right, take it easy. No. No. All right, good. Titanite chunks. Large titanite chunk. I don't even know where the fuck I'm going. Lightning bolts. Alright. Literally lightning bolts. For a crossbow. Okay, so he's just like waiting down there, I guess. How the fuck do you plunging attack him? Try plunging attack. Oh, this is gonna hurt. A little bit. Oh, fucking knew it. Come on, come over here. I don't want to fight you there. Whoa! It's a big one? Oh, this is a bad place to fight, dude. Go away. Dude. He's faster than me. There we go. Fucking one Estus. You'd be kidding. No. Oh, what is he doing? Great. Well, that's what I was saving my one Estus for. What? Is this the end of the boss room? Can you just exit? Oh, fuck. Oh, well, there he goes. I don't think so. I think you gotta continue upwards and onwards. From there. I think you plunge attack it from there. This is pretty fucking cool still. Please tell me I'm not going the wrong way. Ah, pointless. There's an item. What are you talking about? Twinkling? That wasn't pointless. Fuck you on about, dude. God damn, he'd be burning this place down so fast. It's no joke. Or plunging attack? What? It was an off switch. Fucking gimmick fights, man. That was pretty fucking cool, though.